the love for Kingdom Hearts and Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is pretty immense. We have a ton of references within Smash thanks to Sora through his moveset, through his classic mode route, from his trailer, and of course, in his spirit board, which is the final spirit board in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Man, it feels so good to say that. Look at that. Kingdom Hearts is right there. And of course, just like all other spirit boards, this contains spirit battles that have really cool references to the character that you're fighting over. So now I'm gonna break down the references that we can find Kingdom Hearts wise in the Kingdom Hearts spirit board in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. If you're down with that, be sure to like, share, and most importantly subscribe to HMK for more awesome videos every week. Let's dive directly into the darkness. Now, for the spirit board, we have Kairi, Ventus, Aqua, Terra, Riku, Shion, Axel, and Roxas. And I like to say that I called the spirit board pretty much to a T, not exactly to the spirit formation, but to some of the levels and other stuff. And some of these battles and references are a lot more simple than the others, but some are actually quite spicy. Alright, let's begin with Kairi. In this one, Kairi is played by Daisy, which makes a lot of sense considering the red hair and the whole flower motif, since Kairi is all about that. And she's even holding the lipstick item, which is supposed to represent the Destiny's Embrace. That's actually really cool. And the battle takes place on Tortimer's Island, which is supposed to represent Destiny Islands, and Sora does show up in order to help her out in this battle. Pretty cool, Sakurai. Pretty cool. Alright, let's get on over to Ventus. Ventus here is played by Sora, of course, which takes place in the Gerudo Valley, which is supposed to represent the Keyblade Graveyard. And then in the battle, Dark Samus shows up with a Killing Edge. And the Dark Samus coloration kind of makes me get reminded of a certain other character in Kingdom Hearts. That's right, it's supposed to be Vanitas. So that's a pretty cool battle. And then we come to Aqua, that is played by Lucina. Nice. And with the Knight of Fate and the area of Find Me, it suggests that this is either supposed to be a torn up Destiny Islands like we saw in 0.2, I mean the background kind of matches that, or the Realm of Darkness. For this spear battle, it gets a little hanky-panky on what exactly we're supposed to represent in what moment in time in the game, because obviously the little Game & Watches are supposed to be Heartless, little Shadows, or maybe they're supposed to represent the Devil's Tide. And Crystal shows up at one point in the battle, and I feel that could either represent Aqua as well with her magical ability, or supposed to represent Anti-Aqua or Phantom Aqua as the match is going on with Lucina already being Aqua. What do you guys think it's gonna be? Leave a comment in the comment section below. Alright, now we get to Terra. Now, this one is interesting. Crom is Terra, and I definitely understand giving the color representation of Crom's clothes, but the battle takes place within Terra's heart, as per his Station of Awakening is there in the background from the Dive to Heart. And then Ashley shows up. Now, I personally believe that Ashley is supposed to represent Nominate, as it is revealed in Kingdom Hearts 3 and in Kingdom Hearts 3 Remind that Nominate is the one that called out to Terra's spirit in the Lingering Will in order to assist the heroes when the timeline got reset. And the fact that Nominate was called a witch that had power over Sora's memories, and Ashley being a witch, I feel that this could indeed be the case. Alright, now we get to Riku. And Corrin is Riku. I mean, there must have been a better pick for this, but I mean, whatever. And we're at Hollow Bastion. Here, Corrin uses a black hole item, and since it's Hollow Bastion, that's pretty much Kingdom Hearts 1, where we had to fight Dark Riku, or Riku using the dark outfit, whatever. And that's pretty much it. And now, we move on to Shion, with Lady Robin being Shion, with a black coat and everything. Here at Delfino Plaza, with the gate in the background, is supposed to represent the Twilight Town Clock Tower. And the homies, Roxas and Axel, are here as well. They're both represented by male Robins, and Axel is the taller Robin that spams arc fire because obvious reasons. And Roxas is the smaller Robin and has two swords, because, you know, dual wielding. So that's pretty cool that the Twilight Town trio are together again. Next up, we move on to Axel. And Roy is Axel. Called it, you know, red hair, control over fire, dark clothes. And this is really cool. Now, this area, which is the Kalos Pokemon League, is supposed to represent that one area in the mansion that's all blue, kind of like the Kalos Pokemon League, where Roxas fights Axel. But it moves on over to the fire Pokemon version, just like how Axel says, "I'm so flattered," and then the place goes up in flames. I thought that was a really sick callback. Also, he's throwing around his chakram in the form of a hothead. And then we come down to my favorite Kingdom Hearts character, the Legend class, Roxas. Now, this one is hard. Not hard in the sense of what I'm trying to figure out. Hard in the sense as this battle is pretty spicy. Okay, Sora is Roxas, of course. And this fight reflects the Kingdom Hearts 2 fight between Sora and Roxas. But technically, it's supposed to be Sora's Station of Awakening in the background, not Roxas's. And also, Roxas has two swords. And he's a pretty beefy, and I mean beefy opponent when you're battling him in this spirit battle. And there you have it, the spirit board is now complete. What'd you think about those references, Kingdom Hearts and Smash Fateful? Hey, if you thought there was a different reference in any of the battles, leave your comment in the comment section below, and be sure to share, like, and subscribe to HMK for more awesome videos every week. Big thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping make this video happen. If you want to find out how you can support HMK for just $1 a month, check out my info in the description box below. Alright guys, until the next video, this has been HMK, and I'll check you guys later.